I've been in sports since 2007, fighting for you all. If you all let my fight be in vain, woe be unto you all. I will shake your kingdom of earth. And you are going to fall to the cracks that's going to be left back.
Greetings, people in America and all over the world. Paul Mokler here again. Today is March 29, 2012 at 8:38 p.m. People, haven't I proved to you all that there's no justice in America or the world? There are laws. There are hundreds of thousands of laws. But there's no justice. There's no justice, people. I, Paul Mokler, right? A simple man. As you all know the story before, but I'm going to keep telling it to you all until you all get it. I've been in the federal court and in the state court since 2007 fighting for all the American people and the people in Europe and Africa and all the world, because once Babylon falls, everybody going to be free. So I've been in the court fighting for your people and people. As you all know, I released a video telling you all that Barack Obama and George Bush and Timothy Geithner and them, they defaulted. They did not file their brief on March 27, 2012, as they were supposed to. And I spoke to the clerk, Adam, and he told me he was going to look into it. But as I expected, look, they gave him time, people. Look, they gave them more time. They gave these bums until May 29, 2012 to answer a 10-page brief. People, the complaint against them is 106 pages long, yes. However, my brief is only 10 pages long. People have filed this brief since, what? May? Since April 2011, I filed my brief. They're supposed to answer June 1st, they didn't. Thought they just struck Massachusetts. They're supposed to answer March 27, 2012, they didn't. Straight boom, struck Wisconsin. And people, like I told you all, right, that they're in default. So people, when you're in default, it means that you lost. However, a day later, the court allowed, we don't even asking for extension of time to file, these bums were allowed to file late. But if that was me, my case would have been thrown out. But anyway, that's not the point, people. The point, people, still, I won. People, I won for you all, okay? The Constitution said that rights not granted to the federal government are prohibited by it are reserved to the people and the states. What that mean, people, that the federal government can go on and protect the federal government. The federal courts can go on and protect the federal courts. However, they have no power over the people of the state when the federal government commit crimes against the people. Now we know the federal government is responsible for the bank, regulating the banks. And when the banks commit crimes against the people, it's the federal government responsibility to help the people. Okay? So when the federal government doesn't perform their duty, it's up to the people of the state to pick up arms, if they may, to put themselves, because the federal government has failed them and the federal government have no rights to stop them. So the point being, people, is that I, Paul Mokler, have won this case for you all. And how did I win? Because I won against the 50 governors. People, the 50 governors are in default. The 50 governors of the 50 states defaulted. People, as you can see up there, right, on June 6th, remember I told you all, they were supposed to file their brief by June 1st, 2011. They did not file it. And after I got off the phone with the clerk, tornado struck Massachusetts. Right? Real tornado. And then, people, On June 6th, I called the federal, the 50 states did not file a brief or anything. Neither did Obama or no one. So then, but on June 1st, Barack Obama, George Bush and them filed an appearance and asked for extension of time. But the 50 governors, with the audacity, because they think that the 11th Amendment protects them, they decided to just sit back and relax. I did not respond to my brief or my complaint with the audacity. But people, those of you who really know about the US Constitution, the 11th Amendment is unconstitutional because it overthrew one of the original Constitution, one of the original laws, which say that the federal courts have jurisdiction over controversies between states and citizens of other states. So which means if California, which is the home state of Fremont Investment and Loan, the fifth top predatory lender in the country, when Fremont Investment and Loan come to Massachusetts and give me a loan and falsify my loan application and say that my mother is employed when she is not, and say my mother is making $9,846 a month when she is not, because she's only making $345 from Social Security benefit, because the banks went in there and did their own loan application and falsified my mother's signature. And anyway, I'm going off. The point I'm trying to make is that the banks just coming forward against all the people, right? And when I sued the banksters, I realized that in order for me to protect all the people also, help all the people also, I gotta sue the banksters' bosses also. So if the banksters get away, I will have their bosses cornered. So that's why I sue all the banks in one lawsuit and all the bosses in another one, and I tried to join them, but the federal court protected them and separated the cases. So I abandoned the one against the bank and I'm concentrating on this one now. So now people, like I was saying, people, the 50 governors with the audacity believe that the 11th Amendment could protect them, decided not to answer to my complaint. But like I was saying, the 11th Amendment overthrew an original rule which say that the federal courts have jurisdiction over controversies between one state and a citizen of another state. So, when Fremont come to Massachusetts with their fraud, I have a right to sue California for not regulating Fremont. And I have a right to sue Massachusetts for allowing Fremont to come into our states and not regulating them either. And because Massachusetts court's gonna protect Massachusetts and California court gonna protect Fremont and California, there's only one person left who could honestly decide this controversy, and it is the federal courts. That was their purpose. But the federal courts now squandered their power and gave in to the states with the 11th Amendment, because it was a trick to begin with. Anyway, they all work together. The federal government and the state government work together. They protect each other. So anyway, so people, on June 6, 2011, I called Adam and asked him to default the 50 governors. And like he told me he was gonna look into to default the federal government, he told me he's gonna look into it also. And then within 1 hour, I got this notice. I'm gonna read it to you, see? Entered June 6, 2011. And he called the name, he said the name of the 50 governors. They was in, when I filed this complaint, people, these are the governors who was in charge. So the last will go to their successors, okay? Okay, he said right here on page, let me read it to you. He said, and he says, the last name, he said Jim Gibbons, at the second to last, third to last line, Jim Gibbons failed to file an appearance. Okay, it's all the 50 governors, right? But the Jim Gibbons failed to file an appearance and a brief, and therefore will not be heard at oral argument except by permission of the court. Okay, so federal rule. So people, what that means, right? These people will not be heard at all because they didn't even file an appearance. So how can they be heard by permission of the court if they never even file an appearance, with their audacity thinking that they are protected by the 11th Amendment? How people? So people, how can the state be heard ever again? They have lost. Because they have lost because people, they had no answer to my complaint. The state courts are giving out hundreds of thousands of foreclosure orders as if they give out candy on Halloween. When under the United States Constitution, the state court have no right to give our property to foreign banksters, even if they own it. These foreign banksters have no right to come into our country and foreclose on our homes. And people have won for you, people. At default, the default, I have won. I've asked that the court order that the state government order a cease and desist against every foreclosure in the state. So people, why these people, this has been since June 6, 2011. Why from June 6, 2011 until now, March 28, 29, 2012, people still losing their home when I have won for you all? Why haven't the federal government put out a notice and tell the people, tell the state, you must cease and desist from all foreclosure because Palmer Club won? You all have defaulted, he has won against you. I've asked him to do it, people. Why have not the state look at this and realize that they have lost and have ordered a cease and desist order against all foreclosure in this state? So people, you know what this means? The state don't care about you. So powers not granted unto the federal government are provided by it are reserved to the people in the state. But however, when the state have lost a lawsuit, it means it's being granted to the people. So that means the people have a right to do what? To stop paying your mortgages. The sheriff have no right to serve foreclosure notices. Okay? The police have no right to go and evict anyone from their homes. Because police, I have one for you too. Police, sheriffs, you are a government agent. But first, you are citizens of your state. So you have an obligation to your state and the citizens, not to the government. To the citizens. To yourself and your family, your cousin, your uncle. You have an obligation to them that they're not kicked out of their homes. You have an obligation to them that you keep your home also, because I have one for you too. And even the federal agent, like my good friends in the federal marshal, you know, those in the Secret Service, you all know who you are. Remember you told me about putting on my mask in the airplane before I could save anyone else? You gave me that advice. Now I'm advising you. Put on your mask and help me save the people. Put on your mask. I'm giving back your advice. Put on your mask and help me save the people. Help me stand for the people, because I have won. I have won for the people. First, you are citizens of your state, and then you are federal agents. Stand up for my help. I plead my cause to you, federal agents, federal marshals, my friends. Plead my cause to your friends. Help me stand up for the people. I have won for the people. I have won. Plead my cause, O Lord, with them that strive with me. So people, I need ending because I only have a couple more seconds left. I ask the sheriffs, the police, everyone who have power, stand up for the people, because I have won for them. The government have default. They are barred from even being heard. I have won. And my demand was to cease and desist all foreclosure in your state and to return the people's jobs, to get the people's job. Okay, No more mortgage payment. The guy won. Section 305 of the Uniform Commercial Code. When a creditor is caught committing fraud in the factum, he loses everything. And the person who gained the credit takes everything, including what he paid. Section 305 of the UCC Code. Respect it. One love, one heart, one destiny to all humanity.